Welcome to Lime Rock Park in Connecticut. Here is the starting lineup of the Country Time at the Lime 3rd Annual Race. On the pole, Road Ringer Tim McDonnell. Second, Matt Raboyne comes in. I should probably write this down. Give me one second. Oh, yeah. Got the information. Let's see. Thought I already had it written down. Oh yeah. All right. Let's see. On the pole, Tim
Drivers
McDonnell,
to your car.
Road Ringer, and points leader. Second, Matt Raboyne, Valvoline. Eighth in points. Third, Tony Pizarro, your real points leader. And winner last week at New Hampshire. Fourth, Jimmy Stevens, 13th in points. Scott Jackson, 10th in points. 6th, John Batista, 4th in points. 7th, Zach Michael, hot consistency, 20th in points. 6th in points. 8th, the real Road Ringer, David Baldinger. 9th, John Tharp, 15th in points, 10th, looking for road win number 2 of 2021, Alex Crapser, 7th in points, 11th, rookie Mark Huron, 12th, Adam Crapser, 13th, Dalton Lucas, 14th, Alan Nesfetter. 15th, Matthew Dominique, 17th in points. 18th, another top 20 qualifying run, Steven Spears. 19th, Jonathan Skrabix. 20th, having a stroke, Donald Stewart. Zach Miller, 16th in points. Battle of the Beverages, Beepus and Budweiser, Ben Gear. Ryan Heuser comes in 11th in points after engine failures. Michael Henson. Wasp Row, Bill Werkheiser. Randy Dobbins. Mark Guthrie, Tony Long, Dakota Wilkins, Mark Murphy, Rookie of the Year contender, Connor Germain. Good battle between him and Wilkins this season. And Mike Carroll, almost won this race last year in the spam car. Dan Johnston, Rob Scarberry, Christian Torres, David Butterworth. A lot of great drivers in the last four rows. Ken Pettit, 5th in points. Rick Jackson, 12th in points. Tex Perry. Aaron Cummings. Dave Miller, 14th in points. Glenn Kaufman. Craig Lee, 3rd in points. Johnny Reed Foley, 9th in points. If you look at the sky, it is clear. If you look at the people, they are excited. If you look at the catch fence, it looks very dangerous. Have not taken in on the issues of the Forest Grove accident 3 years ago. In fairness, he did not hit the catch fence. Guardrail is what I'm trying to say. Maybe a catch fence would help. I guess if you hit a catch fence, the wall is so close to the track, they just bounce back on the track. And the people are way over there, so if it flips, it'll take a long time to get there. Actually, there is a fence right behind or in front of the people. How do the people see the race from over there? Oh my God. It's like watching from some kind of vortex. They're thousands of feet away. Tough break for the spectators. You should watch on television. There's also a river right next to the track. I think my window might be open. 1 second. My window is not open. Someone's just being really loud. Enter the Michelin straightaway. One of the shortest straightaways in extravaganza. Could really use some French fries right now, but I am on a diet. Current diet is pickles, wheat bread, cheese, ham, turkey or pastrami, apple juice sometimes, mostly water. Coffee, sometimes. Let's get this spectacle underway. Laps, third annual, Lime Rock Country Time at the Lime. Green flag is out. McDonald at the point, 2x2 behind. Battle for the lead, 12 and 22. Cesaro. Tharp gets by Batista. Huron taking a look under Aldinger. Spears and Nesfetter will pass the 29. I stand corrected. Foley and Kaufman side by side. Foley has gained 3 spots since the restart. Ken Pettit, race for 36. And Germain will take this. Dakota Wilkins and Guthrie. 77. Keep the spot. For fourth, Jimmy Stevens and Scott Jackson. both on the edge of the chase cutoff. Two has it. 38 drops back under pressure from Domino's. I will get a drink. I will be back in a few. Boyne loses two spots. McDonald to second, Stevens to third. Dominique to 11th. Dominique to 10th. McDonald is closing in on the 12. Tim McDonald, your new leader. Second lead change of the day. First was on lap 1, second on lap 15. Pizarro, third lead change. Side by side again. 12 will let him take it. New leader, McDonald. Fourth lead change. Sixth, John Tharp, Scott Jackson. Sharp goes by, John Batista goes by. Two for one. Once more, 12 and 22. 12 will take it. Fifth lead change in 20 laps. Oh my. And again. McDonald, sixth lead change, 21 laps. Behind, 39 passes, 14, sixth. Not gonna do it this time. Baldinger passes Scott Jackson for eighth. Thank you. 8 seconds behind the leader. He will pass Aaron Cummings for 41st. For the lead, 7th, lap 29, Bizarro has the spot. Two equally matched cars, neck and neck, pulling away from the field. Again. McDonald again. Batista by 2 for 5th. Thank you. for 19th, Mark Guthrie and Steven Spears, Old versus New. Guthrie will take the spot. Wilkins on the aggressive. Crapser, 7th in points. Scott Jackson, 10th. Battling for 9th. Speedy, 8th. Looking to break back in. John Tharp, Baldinger. Tharp up to 7th. Baldinger back to 8th. Baldinger won the Daytona Bonanza Race, looking to capture another workhorse victory today. The two leaders, McDonald and Pizarro, 2 points leaders, 2 leaders of this race, ahead by 2 seconds. Leader is 2-2, second is 1-2, three is 2-0. Lots of twos. Good thing today is not Tuesday. Baldinger on the charge. 7th. Baldinger will take the spot. Batista. Fourth. 100 laps to go. McDonnell, your leader. Pizarro, second. 1-2 punch at the front. Battle for the lead. Ninth time. Pizarro gets it. Lead again. Double digits. Number 10. Caterpillar. Fenway Park. The cat will win. The park will not. McDonald at the helm again. Fastest lap of the race is Dakota Wilkins, 110.3. and 20. And last lap, John Batista, as he passes the 20 for third, got his fastest lap of the race, second best of the day. Late tires saving his tires, John Batista. Batista has caught the leaders. Heartbreak at Sonoma. Almost won Sonoma. After 18 laps, blew up with a 10-second lead. Thank you. steak. And Pennzoil wins over the beat up rock band. 04 to 10th, 38 outside the top 10, but inside the top 10, in the points. Guys behind him, Ryan and Rick, not doing as well. Ryan progressing through the field, but still not near the top. And green flag pit stops might be happening here. Got Dalton Lucas and Mark Guthrie. One lap down. Should have to make maybe two stops. I remember last year was 70 laps. I'm probably wrong. So this is the definition of short pitting. Tim McDonnell keeping a distance from the 39. For the lead. JB underneath. Tim doing what he can to hold on to second. Side by side to the front stretch. 39 on top. Pizarro will get the spot. Tim back to third. And that's about it. Zach Michael. Just letting them race in front. JB pulling some distance. O'Connell, Zach Michaeliv. Here we go. Green flag pit stops have commenced. 1/3 of the field is in. John Tharp, Alex Crapser, Scott Jackson. Dave will be trapped one lap down. He's 14th in points, needs a much better day. McDonald with the lefts. And Michael out quick, so is McDonald. Still come out ahead of last place. Johnny Reed Foley still. And John Batista is in. Heavy traffic. Pizarro in. Matt Rapaloni here. JB comes out in front. Perfect stop. He will come out ahead of McDonald. And Matt Raboin may still be out there. Nope, he's in. Leader in. Batista will retake the lead. Stop for the 87 crew. Dominique back in the sway, in the lead pack. Aldinger in the lead pack, and 87 in the lead pack. Not much has changed, but the pace of the leaders should be quicker. Batista ahead by 2.5 seconds. Lap traffic. Aldinger underneath Dominique. Fifth for Aldinger. Sixth for Dominique. Tim McDonald takes second. Zach Michael takes third. Pizarro back to fourth. Batista very stuck behind lap traffic. Battle for 41st, Glenn Kaufman. Batista on the outside. Glenn's gonna give him room. Batista laps Glenn. His attempt. Glenn's gonna widen the gap. Lots of lap traffic ahead. Holy moly. Coming to the halfway bacon bonus in two laps. Tim better hurry. Batista with the move of the century. Looks like Glenn is last, Butter is second to last. Still no cars, but two cars. One lap down. Both cars are blue. One lap to go for the bacon bonus. John Batista will win the halfway bacon bonus. Congratulations. Going for win number 5 today. Redemption for Sonoma. Tharp loses two. News 3. Tharp 9th. Rapser 8th. Raboin 7th.
Yeah.
Rick Jackson going one lap down. Huge. 39, 22, and 20. All within each other. Next lap, 60 to go. Caution free so far.
Thank you.
caution flag is out. Oh, going green. Okay. Well, let's see what happened first. Debris caution. Holy smokes. Great break for Ken Pettit, Dan. Oh my God. Well, maybe not a great break for Ken Pettit. John Batista knows the championship is on the line. Do not give Ken his lap back. He might regret it later. All right, time for green flag pit stops. And Ken Pettit will lose a lap. Horrible for the points. He comes in fifth, may come out outside of the top 10. All right. Let's see what happens. And Dan also loses a lap. Whoa! Oh my God! Three wide. Johnny Reed Foley, barely hanging on all day, gets another shot. Better speed up so we can catch to the field. Oh, what is this? Who's leading? Mark Huron, Randy Dobbins, and Zach Miller stay out. Dakota Wilkins is your leader. He stays out. New leader, Dakota. This could be interesting. Lots of lap cars trying to get their lap back. Ben Gear and Butter in front. Dan behind. Ken behind. Dakota. Mark. Randy. Zach. Your top four. Green flag is out. Thank you. second, Randy Dobbins and Mark Huron. Dobbins takes the spot. Zach Miller. Side by side for third. Miller will get third. Batista. Past the lap traffic in fifth. Doing everything he can to hang on. And Huron underneath Miller. Side by side action through the inner loop. To no avail. Miller keeps fourth. Third. Michael Henson on the same strategy. Henson looking for a good day, not his best season. The rookie. Last year, Mike Carroll, the rookie, nearly won this race. This was the first race of the Colorado Rockies scheme by David Baldinger last season in the 121. Can Dakota conquer the upset victory at Lime Rock? Can he make it on fuel? Lap both of the All-State teammates. The aforementioned Mike Carroll, the third teammate, inside the top 20. This year, some very good finishes as of late. Looking for another road course victory. He won here last year. Can he do it again? That didn't pit are are still 1, 2, 3, 4. Huron underneath Miller. Very low. The high-octane teammates have passed Dakota. Here comes Randy. Here comes the field. Tim McDonald and Michael Henson have passed the 39. Dobbins. Miller will come out on front. Two rookies inside the top four. The other two have never won at a road course. And neither have won this season. Randy is looking to make it three in a row. As in, three wins in the last three seasons. Sorry, four wins in the last three seasons, but three in a row. Extravaganza, 77, 30, 96, 01. Batista underneath Michael Henson. For seventh, he will take the spot. third, Huron Dobbins. Randy better be careful. Huron the third. Stack up behind. First and second are neck and neck, Rockies and Beavis, Chevrolet and Ford, purple and black. crawling back. Michael asked Dobbins, Huron, will we get past 77? Rookie battle. Six in, he cannot make it. That will surely be his last stop. Tough break for the 96. .39, .20, and .144. Great battle for fourth. 39 will win. Henson doing everything he can with those old tires. Henson will get the spot up to six. Somebody else is in. Zach Miller into pit. 21 laps to go. Huge disappointment. Came in 15th in points. 16th in points. Stay on the lead lap. And he will stay ahead of Dobbins and Huron, who also pit. Can Dakota make it the rest of the way? And can he win his first extravaganza race? Things looked good. Led a few laps at Pocono in a top five starting spot. Looks to be stronger as the season goes on. His friend Jeremy Hebel fired from the Alex Crapser team. Now, looking for redemption as the Rockies machine leads. Coming to 19 to go. Battle for the lead. Here come the big guns. Tim McDonnell. Here comes John Batista. 77 holds him off.
Whoa!
And it's a no-go for Wilkins. Heir of the Wilkins Coffee Company. Thought I saw three wide there. Here comes Wilkins. A footnote in a great, great strategy. Not a good stop. He will be behind the 96, the 30, and maybe the 01. And let's take a look through the field. We've got Mark Huron and Rob Scarberry also made a pit stop, so tough break for him. Dan Johnston is pulling away from the pack. He's 32nd, got his lap back, but can he keep it? Rob Scarberry, Mark Huron, Dakota Wilkins, Randy Dobbins, Michael Henson, Ben Gear, Dave Butterworth. Gear Butterworth one lap down. And Zach Miller all tried to make the great A strategy, making it on fuel, could not do it. Dalton Lucas, 25th place, last on the conventional lead lap. Christian Torres, 24th. Hanging on for a good day. Argentinian road skills in play. Steven Spears looking for another top 20 finish. Just needs three more spots and a teammate ahead. Mark Huron, 22nd. Mark Guthrie needs a good day outside of the top 35 in owner's points. Had to qualify in, did it successfully. Unfortunately, he is battling the 50 and the 65, and they are right with him. And there he is. Mike Carroll nearly won this race a year ago. Top 20 run. Johnny Reed Foley in last several times early in the going. Just like Zach Michael last week, Foley is flying through the field. Needs a good finish today. He came in ninth in points, and he might drop a spot to Ryan if he does not keep up the pace. Tex Perry, 18th, still on probation from the Ben Gear accident as he battles Tony Long, who's having a great day inside the top 20. Tex will take the spot. Here comes Foley. Up front, it's still 22, 39, and 20, your top three. Foley gains one more spot, up to 18th. Bill Werkheiser in clean air, 16th. Good run for him at a road course. Here's the Jackson, Scott Jackson, 15th. Not a superb run, looking for his second road course win of the season. He won Sonoma. Needs a lot to happen to win today. And might drop a spot in the points to Ryan, who's four spots ahead. One guy who's really struggling, Rick Jackson. just down on speed today. He's 12th in points. He'll drop further back and maybe miss his second straight chase. Adam Crapser inside the top 15 all day. 14th. 13th, Alan Nesvedder. Solid run. Matt Raboin, 12th. He is 8th in points coming in. He will maintain that to some extent today. Ryan, after being behind early, catching back up, 11th. No engine failures so far. Good deal. If he can just not have those, he should rack back up into the chase. Donald Stewart might actually get a top 10 this season. What a blessing that would be for this team. Horrifying season for the 55. Who would have thought a good finish would come at a road course? Although it's not over yet. Dave Miller came in 14th in points, down on speed all day, struggling. Rick, Zach, and Dave Miller are going to have a huge, huge disadvantage for the last three races. Alex Crapser, 9th. Probably won't get another win, but another good finish. Came in 7th in points, should stay there. Connor Germain, staying in the points battle for the Rookie of the Year, but Dakota Wilkins really took charge today. Ken Pettit, 35th. He has buffer room. Came in 5th in points, but may drop out of the top 10. Very possible. A 35th place run. Craig Lee has more buffer room. He might drop a spot in the points, but he came in 3rd, over 100 points ahead. Jimmy Stevens, great run, looking to get back on track after his Cinderella story came to a halt. And Matthew Dominique going for another good finish. Finally, his season is starting. John Tharp, 15th in points coming in, has some right damage from the pits. But a 6th place finish will do him justice. Should pass the 44 and the 90 today. And Tony Pizzaro, also some left side damage. Led some laps early, looked really fast. Still on pace for a top 5. The points leader. David Baldinger, 4th. The Road Ringer, still in deep contention here. Hazard of Allstate in front. 3rd, Zach Michael. Great day. Inside the top 5 all day. Looking to catch the pack. 8 laps to go. 2nd is John Batista. Doing a whale of a job. Clearly one of the fastest today, looking to trump Ryan for most wins on the season with 5. Might get the 3rd in points. Craig has not had a good run. Here comes Tim. Here comes JB. Oh my. JB passed Rob Scarberry. Lap traffic ahead. Tim trying to erase those morbid thoughts from last year. In that very corner, made a mistake and cost himself the win. Won the previous year as an average finish of 1.5 at this facility. Michael passed the 42. It's a five, maybe, nope, a five-man race if we stay under green. Only one caution for debris. We have just barely crossed the two-hour mark. Will be the fastest extravaganza race of the season. If we can stay green. Michael, trying to hang on. Baldinger, trying to pass the lap traffic ahead. Batista is there. Four to go. Michael gains 2.5 tenths. Baldinger underneath the 42, and he will clear him. Four-man race with 3 laps to go. Batista is there, right on the bumper. Caterpillar versus food. Who will triumph? Michael is coming. Lap traffic may not play a factor. Baldinger is there if all three wreck. 2 laps to go. Here it is. Batista underneath, McDonald on the outside. JB's got the spot. Can Zach take second? No, he can't. Side by side for second. JB is gone. Here comes Baldinger. Several cars in the pits. Can they make it on gas? Bill is in, Glenn, Tex, and others. The 39 is gone. Battle for second. Zach's got it. And Baldinger clears the 22. Here comes John Batista. Wendy's, number 5. We're going to have $5 Baconators at Wendy's after the 5th victory from John Batista. First at Lime Rock. First at a road course this season. So far, our road course winners include Alex Krapser, Road America, Scott Jackson, Sonoma, and John Batista, Lime Rock. Our 3 winners at Lime Rock finish inside the top 4: McDonald 2019, Michael 2020, and JB 2021. McDonald with second to last lap heartbreak again. Should have led the most laps. Good points day. Great points day for John Batista. Looking for his first championship in his decade-long career. Our final results. John Batista, your winner. Zach Michael, second. David Baldinger, a third place, one of the best he's ever had. Tim McDonald drops to fourth. Tony Pizarro, your points leader, maintains in fifth. John Tharp, sixth. Great points day. He will be very close to the cut line. Came in 15th. He'll boost a lot. Matthew Dominique, 7th. Jimmy Stevens, 8th. He might be in the chase as well right now. With Foley and Scott Jackson not having the best of days. Alex Krapser, 9th. Donald Stewart, a top 10. Ryan Heuser, 11th. Much better day than lately. Alan Nesfetter, 12th. Matt Raboin, 13th. He will stay about 8th in points. Scott Jackson, 14th. That might take him out, but he might be ahead of Foley now. It'll be interesting to see how that shakes out. It's about a 4-way tie for 10th. Adam Krapser, 15th. Johnny Reed Foley, 16th. He will probably drop one spot. Mark Murphy, 17th. Mike Carroll, 18th. Tony Long and Christian Torres, your top 20. Then Mark Guthrie, Dalton Lucas, Steven Spears, Zach Miller, heartbreak, and Randy Dobbins, your top 25. Michael Henson, 26. Dakota Wilkins with a great sponsor show, leading many laps today. And Mark Huron, 28th. Lap down cars who pitted include Bill Werkheiser, Rob Scarberry, Dan Johnston, Tex Perry, Aaron Cummings. Bad day for Craig Lee, Connor Germain, Ken Pettit, and Dave Miller, and Rick Jackson. Those 3 are taking a huge hit. Ken can afford it. Dave and Rick cannot. They will have to win out to make this chase. Dave Butterworth, 39th. Ben Gear, 40th. Glenn Kaufman, the only car 2 laps down. And a problem for Jonathan Skrabix. He does not finish the race in last. Only 1 caution. No crashes all day. Might be the first time that's happened this season. Unbelievable race. Good job, John Batista.